Orana katoa and welcome to this Tagata Pasifika summer special. We're doing a deep dive into our TP Plus stories.
No ia e Māori, 2022 marks some incredible community events led by our very own Pasifika leaders, from open talanoa about gang violence, the brown butterbean food banks, and the 700-kilometre Uso bike ride.
But the start of 2022 was also marked by devastation. The January 15 eruption in Tonga ravaged many homes and businesses, including the Hatafu Beach Resort.
Tell me about the situation right now. What does it look like?
Oh, you know, we got heartbreaking video footage and photos yesterday of the extent of the damage. As my sister said when I spoke to her via satellite phone, it looks like a bomb had gone off on the western side, because there's just all the houses and the businesses across that western coastline are just completely devastated. And then that filters into Tukanukupolu as well. That village, there's extensive damage there. You have to wonder, you know, by the grace of God, how so many people were not badly affected. Health-wise, and it's a miracle.
How is your family doing? The ones who are at Hatafu, and also, were there any guests as well? Where are they now?
Yeah, well, there were guests during, so they were doing like a catering for guests when the first eruption, when the big eruption happened at about 5:30. And as soon as the eruption happened, from what I've heard, it was so violent that, they knew something was bad was happening. And from 10 minutes after the eruption, the first wave had hit. So Mo and Hola and the kids and the staff were getting people out of the resort, and they didn't have time to save anything. By the last car getting out of the resort, the water was already up to the back, and they had to sort of flee through the bushes and get into a passing vehicle. So they weren't able to save anything at all.
So this evening was to bring our communities together, talk as one. We had young people here, young mothers and fathers. We had the older men, the whaikawa groups. But also we had people here who lived the life, who were in the gangs, who went inside, and some of them shared their testimonies tonight. It was amazing. It was also quite moving to hear those stories.
For me, for parents, when they start wearing red or blue, when they start doing gang signs, you need to understand, what is it?
So you're saying that parents should look up for signs? But how do they know the signs? If you don't know what those things are, how do you know?
They're all just a product of the system. They grew up in the boys' homes, girls' homes. They're neglected as kids, no lunch, no breakfast. And those kids that are pushing in the centre and all that, if you're making $1,000 a week, school's out of session, man. Why would you want to go back to school?
This is not just about how do we stop them from getting into gangs. What exactly is quite dysfunctional in our family structures, our social structures, our cultural structures, that allows or makes our children seek that validation.
So today we're here to pick up kai for our community of Manurewa. We're here due to the the support that Dave has with his community and networks to bring in kai refresh. So we're here to be able to give some kai and some happiness and joy really to our whānau for the long weekend.
We're lucky and blessed to be working alongside Fresh. So today, alongside all of the stuff we normally do, we've got, another, I think, 400 boxes to give out to families as well. Mark from Fresh contacted me. He contacted me on LinkedIn and said that he's doing this, had this idea, and I said, I'm keen to be a part of it. So any way that we can connect business to our community is, I'm all about it. If you're struggling normally, and then you've got, all of a sudden you've got a, a weekday of the kids being home, so eating more food, you got everyone home. It's just, things like this takes pressure off.
It's quite sad to see a lot of our whānau come through the marae and, you know, basically they're asking for food and sometimes they're not asking, they're demanding. And now I'm seeing, we're seeing at the marae, it's a lot of, so working class whānau as well now, so it's not just our whānau that are on benefits and that now, it's also our whānau that work on a daily basis like myself and, you know, they're earning decent amount of money. And yet they are coming in now to ask for some kai parcels.
You know, the cost of living has increased. Petrol, kai, basic needs are so hard for our whānau now. You got whānau that are in two income families that are still struggling. And they're a new group of whānau coming to access resource like this, eh? And we want to be able to get more support to our whānau out there for kai.
This is, like, as far as I know, like the fourth Uso ride that you guys have planned since 2016. A couple of big rides down country, East Coast. Now this ride to Porirua. How are you feeling about this?
Excitement first and foremost, but also an opportunity. An opportunity to, I guess, showcase cycling to the community.
I find it personally nothing more exhilarating than trying to be an example. Yeah. To my own family, but hopefully others as well, by riding my bike and showing that being active is part of the wellbeing message.
Probably the last year I've been training for this ride, and 2 weeks ago I had to pull out because I've had a bit of a health issue with my heart. So I'm taking a step back and I'm going to support the crew going forward. Yeah, so it's going to be totally different for me.
Something different this time around. You've got some local boys here from Mangere who are going to be coming along with you guys. Important to spread the message wider?
Yeah, no, that's really exciting. I mean, Auckland and Mangere being the capital of the Pacific, and, you know, our reach is, you know, towards the Pacific people. So, you know, to have a couple of the local boys from Mangere join us, you know, that's exciting.
But I think it's also important for our communities to see different people, different sizes, different ages. And because we all get inspired by different things, and I think that's a key part of what people are going to see us riding down the country.
Welcome back as we continue to feature our community TP Plus highlights. 2022 was the year many of our wahine toa in the community were celebrated and championed. We caught up with these legends of stage and screen.
And we spoke to the very first female Pro Vice Chancellor Pacific at the University of Auckland. But with all that hard work, a lot of these community leaders deserve a bit of pampering.
I think it's the importance of having a break, having a breather. So you've got businesswomen here, you've got community leaders, everyone dedicates a lot of time to our communities because we know the importance of serving our communities. But at the same time, we need to make sure that our kites are full so that we can serve our people. So this is all about coming together, like-minded women, just having a breather, having a break, and acknowledging the importance of having the rest, yeah.
For me, it's just our women take time out for themselves. Like, the name of the event is Ladies Make Time. So we're saying, actually, make time for yourselves. We're telling you to do that because, you know, us as Pacific, we have a lot of falabilaves, and, you know, we always put the priority on that. And also women, they're all about their family, so they always put the family first and not themselves. So we said, you know what, please make time for yourself. We'll make it easy for you. You just come.
See, now if you ask me to give you something and to help you to do something, no problem. Instantly. It's part of our natural upbringing. But for you to say to me, can you please come, sit down so I can give you something, that is something that I have to work myself up towards to say. It could also be said that some of us actually have to stop just to say, oh, that's right, I'm okay to do this. Oh, I have to allow myself permission just to sit in this chair.
I've been in the business for over 45 years, but in the last 10 years, I really, really learned a huge amount about what art is and how integrated it is to the whole of Pasifika in particular, but also Te Ao Māori. You can't separate art from life. It artists all. It is part of all. But what I have learned is that the thing I suspected, which was that the talent in the South is off the charts, is true.
This place, you know, when you think of Mac, straight away think of Alison, the team that she brought in and trusted, you know, and now she leaves the team in the capable hands, and it's all because of her. You know, this place is a testament to her. It wouldn't be the same without her. I truly believe that.
We existed to promote Pacific young people living and growing in Aotearoa, telling Pacific stories through all the arts mediums, performing arts in particular. When we came to Auckland, we found Alison and in this place doing exactly the same as where we came from.
It's such a beautiful thing to witness, like tonight. You know, I just cried from the first performer that came out. You know, because, yeah, I mean, I've seen so many shows there. You know, all of these companies and organisations that have had young people, this is the place that they've come to.
I signed up with an agent, and then, you know, commercials started rolling, Cadbury. I got to fly down to Dunedin and film a commercial for Spades and the rest. And now I'm the national face of a bank. And all that was possible because of you, Alice.
How are you feeling right now?
Very overwhelmed, but very much loved and just soaking in just all this celebration and having my family here and the leaders of the university and students and staff. It's, the words can't express. I didn't get here alone, you know, it's just an extension of everything our parents and our grandparents had worked hard for. So that's why I was emotionally charged. You're born into greatness, as Pasifika, we're born into this greatness, and so it's inevitable. It's just which way we choose, or if we open our ears to heed the voices that are speaking to us every day, then you're able to heed what your calling or your duty is to serve, just to serve our people.
Nafanua this year, it's about Nafanua, the war goddess. So it's about the empowerment of women, Pasifika and Māori women. That's what our theme is. It's about their strength, their mana, their courage. It's about empowering women, and also because it's Samoan's 60th year of independence. Last year we did Battles of the Brothers, because those gods were based in Aotearoa. And at the end of that play, the brothers called out to their Pacific cousins to come and help them. There's a lot of warfare going on. They called out to their Pacific sisters to come and help. Nafanua responded. So she came through to Aotearoa. When she came through, the audience went crazy. So we thought, oh, the seed was planted. The audience want Nafanua.
Takurua is quite an ancient form of eating, where it's like the best of the best get together to showcase who they are and what they're about. I used to live in the Cook Islands. I lived there for a year. I had expressed my interest in their stories and their culture, and so they put forward a takurua to show me their myths and their legends, as well as the kai I was receiving. And I just thought, as a chef, I had always missed an ingredient when I'm trying to showcase Māori or Pasifika food. At that point, I realised it was the stories. I was missing the stories.
Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. This show is all about the TP Plus highlights from our online platform. Right now, we're checking out these creative and cultural endeavours.
These next couple of stories explore how our Pasifika roots have inspired these talented knowledge holders and entrepreneurs.
I got into making this watching my grandfather and documenting some of the things that he made over the years. I kept like a little journal and stuff, so, and then moved over here and sort of tucked it away in a box until I took it out about a decade ago, and then got back into carving again and doing things. So. But as a child, yes, I grew up with watching him carve and do woodworking as well. So that was something that is new to me. It's been part of my family history for a long time, especially with my granddad. This one is paki or pakta, used for or practiced by my relatives and families and friends in the district of Chuchu. So this is the one I think was performed in 2018. Only the folks from that district perform it. These are the two versions. I made a brown and a black. So they're influenced, from what I know, or what my grandfather told me about these war clubs. They have their origins in Walesian islands. This is something my grandfather carved and something I have had in my journal. So this is the Penau, a longer version of the Penau, which is the one I've made here. We used for close combat fighting. This is traditional to Rotuma. There's a more cuboid version of this, but this version I've made is a bladed version with sharp blades on the end and a longer staff. Other motifs that I had noted down for my grandfather, I've applied them to this particular war club. All the war clubs I've carved have power shell inlay. I couldn't find a mother of pearl shell, so the closest I could get was power shell, so they have inlays in them.
Finlayson Park School, Siamo Oibotong and Bilingual, Kihonga Hui Oingatu. I have a Maumea of Fight with Mau Koka Anga. Pia koe koka anga ku mau fai, o ku toto atu, koe whikumi ai wha nau nai fai, pia na nau lalanga pe ai ku pesi. Na nau tui, I he tu aniu, o tui aki ai whau, o mau ai ngai ku pesi, tā labe ngai ku pesi I loa ko ia I tō ngāo. Pia o ku lawe mai mai mātu a o tō koni ki he wha nau. Koe mea ku whakao whataha, ko e mauhanga o fetongi ake ngahi mea koloa o tonga o kaike mau I Nusilani, ai ngahi koloa pe I Nusilani. Ko e manioke o fetongi ake a mahawa a, ta ake karasini. Ko e feta aki o fetongi ake ia ai pepa koka anga ko ni o fatau I Nusilani. Pe a maungawe ake foki moi koka, o ku mau whanau na nau whekumi, pe a nau manatui nau pe o ku ngā ue whānau he tā wari-wari moe āti. Pea au nau osi ilo nau tolo e anga hono whio e ngahi kāla, ke mau ai lanu to tonu o hamea au nau whie mau. Ko ia aina koe whānau penina nau hanga o whio e un kāla koe ni, o mau ai e kāla koe ni ke he ngātu.
Kak mau si o whiwhia whānau. Ka mau tonu pe kau whai ako hange ko au ko wala o ngahi ngatu I tonga na te si o pe ka koenu ko te ala. Pa ne onga peo ka nau nau muri ma ngai aki. Ka mau I mahino pe, ilo pe he whanau hiku nau usi ilo pe mau I hiku nau muri pe ak pau ki ngai te ngai mea ngā au e ko ko nau nau o ku mau hiku.
After getting out to Tau's, having a few beers at our local beer spot, which is here in Morningside, we were just talking it over, you know, possibility of us actually brewing this craft beer, which we love to drink on the weekends and that. So from then on, it was spoken about between us and said, yeah, it should be doable. Me and my brother-in-law, my wife as well, the actual co-founders of that's from brewing. Before that, we decided to go through that process of indulging in the pain and of getting the tatau and malu. It was one of those processes that we wanted to sort of bring our identity out as being proud Samoans. We used the actual bat, which is the bitter that's on our backs. We used the bat on the actual logo and the diamond shape of the malu, which we sort of got both on the branding side of it. It sort of inspired us a lot through going through that journey as well. You know, basically once you get that done, you can almost do anything you want in regards to business or any walks of life. So at the moment, now we've got two types of beers. Our first, which is the Spearhead, which is about 6.8% alcohol. It's a nice tropical flavour, good mouthfeel, hints of peach, passion, along the lines of flavour, different profiles. And our second beer, which is the Flying Bat, which would be our signature beer. And that's another hazy IPA, stands at about 6.3%. And that's another one that's sort of a sunshine colour, hazy, with tropical notes as well.
Ooh, I might need a cold one after watching that too. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I think I need one as well.
Well, that ends our show for today. If you've missed any of our stories, don't forget to check out tpplus.co.nz where you can find them all.
Next week, we're throwing it right back to 2021. We'll take a look at our TP Plus series, Araura Inua, following reporter Johnson Riella as he prepares for Te Mai Vanui. Make sure you join us as our summer series continues. Until then, tō whā soifua.
Be somewhere there.